Hi folks, I'm here just trying to fit a bit of extra filming in today as things are starting to get a little bit busy. It's Wednesday morning. Looks like it's going to be a lovely sunny day, so probably couldn't have picked a better day for it. As I say, stuff's now really starting to sort of snowball and things are taking effect, and just trying to get all the organisational stuff done and some bits squared off over there to get open. So very shortly, next couple of days, I'm about to embark on putting 52 car parking spaces in, just over in that direction, and finishing off the exit ramp for the way down and driving out. So that's going to take a bit of concentration. So moving from there into further in the future, over there is about what, 20, 30 yards over there is where Beggars Canyon's going to be, and that's something that I'm looking forward to starting work on. It's going to be what was the best way to put it? It's progressive, but it's going to be bigger jumps and more of a kind of airtime focused jump track, basically. And then across from it, one more, I've had some ideas about putting in a really snaky, classic, old school style, narrow downhill run that will probably be suitable for modern enduro bikes as well. So they're things for the future that I'm looking forward to. So where are we currently? I'm stood on Get to the Chopper, and currently we have these two, and if you've seen, I don't know whether, you know, I've got some people who are quite sort of new followers, and some people are new to the vlogs and vids, and some people have been watching them for the past sort of 12-15 months, so I don't know whether you've seen this or not, probably have, but two jumps here, two choices. So the line choice in is quite quick and quite techy. This one on the left here, I think, is going to be the one that's hit most often. I'll be quite honest with you, it's the one that I hit most often. When I do hit the one on the right, I find that, in all honesty, on this section, on this entrance into it, I've grabbed a handful of brakes to slow it down a bit so that I can hit it. Now, this is fun, don't get me wrong. I built it for the reason of, I looked down this little slope thing and thought, well, I wonder if I can make a jump into it. And when you do hit it, you do get that kind of, there's a bit of a reward thing of, you get the buzz of, whoa, totally managed. You know, I don't have any other, it's an aggressive kicker. There's no real other way of talking about it. But I also think that it's not going to be the most popular of hits. The smaller one, which is only like a large two log stroke, medium sized three log drop, the smaller one's going to be the one that's going to be used most often, and that I can almost guarantee, just because of the run in. The GoPro is shocking for seeing how steep stuff is. You're just gonna have to trust me, and when you get here, you'll see what's going on. One of the good things for having feedback from testers is you can get an idea of how people feel about it, and to be quite honest, not everybody's digging that big jump. So you've already seen footage of Magic Bus, or at least heard me talk about it, or if you haven't, then it's there in the histories of it all. Let's cross. Do you know what? Stuck under the tape. And Magic Bus is about 30 yards that way. And sat in between it is one where, I see we've got a bit of untidiness at the bottom here where I've been felling. And then it goes down into lower elementary. That bit we're going to, it's pretty straightforward, but we're going to leave it for the trail crew in. Once I've got the car park 50 odd spaces sorted out. Right, anyway, so the reason that elementary exists, let's walk up a bit, is so that some of you may know that there's a gap jump and there's a step down into a gap jumper up at the top of Get to the Chopper. Now, again, another thing from testing that has proved to be, was well worth doing some testing, is not everybody was crazy about the step down. That's fine. It was a bit of a 50-50, that one. Half and half as to who were happy to hit it and who weren't. So, stuck a smaller step on the route around on that one. Then, not everybody was crazy about the gap jump, to be honest. Now, the gap, I'll admit, is fairly deep down. It's like a big hole. So that's kind of daunting. Obviously, nobody wants to go in the hole. But distance-wise, I thought it was really, really mellow, the distance. But that added hole in the middle, it's a psychological thing. And I'm sure there's plenty of you guys out there feel the same way. Whoa. So, I had to build in a route around the gap jump. People weren't too comfy with that. What the ultimate idea is, that people are comfy with hitting the stuff. When I get over there onto Beggars Canyon, we are getting into just straight up jump lines and airtime, and that's going to be the focus of Beggars Canyon, hitting it fast as you can. Hopefully, if we can get the design elements that I want in, hopefully it would be possible until you got right to the bottom to run it brakeless. The berms will hold you in, and you'll jump, and you could do the whole thing brakeless. That's the idea, and that's the target. Hope we can achieve that. But if you're concerned about a gap and it weirds you out, then it's my job to, as a facilitator, to find a way of making some tracks that lead up to that. Now, granted, there aren't any man-made features on Magic Bus. There's some old stumps that I've left in the ground that will kick you and jump if you want them, but you've got to go and seek that line out and to hit it. Magic Bus is very much, here it is, guys. It's, you know, this is now natural riding, no surface, and you're going to have to weave in and out of trees and over roots and stuff. So it's a great introduction for that. Get to the Chopper is now, things have got a little bit faster and there's a whole lot more route. So the one in between elementary, what I'm doing is I'm building smaller features, but on here, there's no way this is going to show on GoPro, but maybe it will, I don't know. But on here, I'm playing around with the idea of old school BMX whoops that are completely rollable. You literally go over one and down over the other and away. But also, if you double them, you're going to double the gap on, if you double them, you're going to be able to clear the gap on Get to the Chopper. I'm just going to quickly fly you up here so that you can have a look at the other one. I also need to test, I also need to do a bit more testing on that holding berm and see if it'll hold you to fly in. But you know, these are things that we do now, document them. I can either write them down, or another good way of doing it is making a video. Make some decisions about them. Hold on to them decisions. Go and get these car parking spaces sorted out. And then come back to it. So, just literally running up here. I'm not running, literally running, that's absolute bull. I'm striding up here. So the other one we've got is, there's a double set of doubles right at the top. Now, these tracks in here are from my fully rigid clunker. It's a good way of checking whether you're going to hit chain rings when you're making doubles. But this gap here, let me get down in the hole. Oh, yeah. This gap here, distance from takeoff to landing, I assure you, is the same distance as the gap jump on, oh, do you know what? I'm stood over here. We could do some actual proof. It's the same distance. Here we go. The difference is obviously you've got a step down to come into, but that distance from top of to landing, that might even be less looking at it now. But you know, there's a hole there, and that through testing of that's made people feel uncomfortable. So before I have a drink and a bit sort out, those are the things that I've kind of got to get in my mind. Yeah, actually, to be honest, it's either the same or very, 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 very similar. I should measure it, I should put a tape on it and measure it. But, excuse me, if you double that, I mean, the idea is to ride this track a few times. It brings it, you come out of a corner around here. There's a little single log drop. Out of a corner from up there, single log drop, round this corner, into the doubles, and then into the woods. Totally rideable again, rollable again, by the way. But the idea is if you're not quite ready for get to the chopper, and you want to ride this a few times, there's going to come a point where you're like, screw it, I'm going to go for it and double it. And if you do, then you're totally ready for get to the chopper. That's the idea. The other thing is, because I've got two of these double things in now, there's another one I've identified. I had Watson Belly in here yesterday, helping me out with making some decisions. Again, that might lend into some of the story about the track being called Elementary, my dear Watson. Anyway, that's kind of the story behind it. Every track name on here is going to have some sort of story behind it. Some of them might be a little bit vague, but just ask us if you want to know. So I identified that way down after like turn, oh man, you got me thinking now, it's like after the third berm in, there's another opportunity for another double. So one of the other things today is, and I need to kind of mark this out as well, is I've got three choices on these. The doubles that I've made now are either A, too close together, B, just right, or C, not far enough apart. And I'll know from the kind of speed that you hold out of that third berm as to whether they need to be the same as this, bigger or smaller. So it's another decision to be made today. Later on we'll go over. I do need to have a bit of a sort out and a check up in the car park as well, so later on we'll do that. I've noticed on the timer on this that I've just babbled for 13 minutes. I'm just going to have a bit square up and we'll do a bit of testing and I'll film a bit of that. It might be a bit more interesting. Sorry for the kind of rushed nature. Just I've got quite a few things that I need to fit in today. So try and squeeze this vlog in as well. I'll catch you in a bit. One thing I should just quickly mention as well is a lot of this that you'll see today, it's in the testing phase and it's subject to change. I'll tell you what, actually, just thinking out loud, the build weekend, the Sunday afternoon ride or the build weekend and bedding in the tracks will be another good chance and opportunity to get some testing done on this. Anyway, the reason that it's subject to change is because currently when I rough stuff in, it's, and the shape of things and the distance and the height of things are all an opinion. It's just my opinion. Doesn't really count for anything at all, actually, and testing has really taught me that. As much as I might like to think, oh, you've come up with a great idea there, Ben, that's what that should be like, that means sod all, to be honest with you. You don't get it validated until you get other people riding on it and they go, I'm not hitting that, or I don't feel good about that, can we have a ride around? Or can we change the shape of that? Or actually, if somebody says, yeah, that's okay. That's validation for an opinion. Then at least you've got something, you know, you've got something behind you can say, no, I think it's like this because I have a valid opinion. At the moment, it's a bit of guesswork and just how I feel about stuff. So it's not the be-all and end-all, and things might be changing. And, you know, testing's going to have to occur on here. But for now, for today, as I say, because I'm going to have to walk away from these because I've got buttloads to do over there. I just need to grab this in now and we'll see what we can do. Can anybody tell that I've had like two coffees and a can of energy drink this morning? So tired. I couldn't get to sleep last night. It was literally like 2 o'clock in the morning. Just brain racing and I couldn't seem to shut off. Anyway, what am I boring you with this for? So in the spirit of every day's a school day, lesson one, even with suspension, and obviously you compress your suspension up when you arrive into the transitions of stuff. Both of the doubles, you don't bash your bash guard if you just decide to roll them, which is great news because obviously if we did, then that means grabbing the spade and making some alterations and I'm kind of pushed for time. So that's good news, that's first thing, and our next thing is can you double them? I should add some validity to this actually. I was talking about that before. It sounds a bit pompous and anyway, what I'm trying to say is many of you, you know, we haven't had the opportunity to meet yet and we don't know each other. So just to kind of give you an idea of where my riding's at, I've been mountain biking for a long, long time. I did have a gap in it when I moved to Manchester, but you know, essentially been doing it since I was a kid and before then riding BMX. However, in saying that, just because it's been a long time and a lot of years, doesn't mean I'm any good. I am your average middle-aged man. On a mountain bike, not your Steve Pete, Rob Warner types, you know, they're 40 and obviously they absolutely rock. So I'm the opposite end of the scale of that. I'm your average kind of guy. So what I'm trying to say is if I'm able to double these and I'm able to do the drops and stuff, hopefully that can give you some sort of level and idea of you know, it's just a normal bloke, standard bloke doing it. I don't know whether that can be, I doubt it, but I don't know whether it's been misconstrued before as, oh, the guy, he's opening a bike park, he must be like a really bad rider. No, I'm not, not at all. I just really enjoy it. So anyway, if you see me, if I'm doing it, then hopefully that says that it's within reach of normal people. Right, anyway, we'll crack on that because I suppose I need to find a way of telling myself to double these now that I've built them. Better test them. Well, first try says it's at least doable. I would hope it's doable with a bit more grace though. So at the moment, what seems to make the most sense feeling wise on this one is to just kind of, as you roll in it, just lift the front wheel a little bit. So that leaves me, just had a run in it now, that kind of leaves me disappointed but pleased at the same time. I should explain that I don't want it, it's just out of a corner on purpose. It is supposed to be surprise you a bit and that's the idea of it. And I suppose you get confidence in that corner, hit it a bit harder and you're weighing over it. But it kind of, you know, that's how it's supposed to be. It's not supposed to be that you can just fly into it and hit it first time dead easy. Maybe, is it going to be different on a light trail bike that's a bit more sort of flickable and everything? I don't know. Am I going to get like three more runs into it and just be like, oh, scratch that, just double it and do it? I don't know. But again, you know, that's the thing that's kind of pleasing about it. You don't want to make it just really obvious. Otherwise, it's got no progression to it, is it? It's just straightforward. And anyway, as I say, it feels like just like kind of like leaning back a little bit and letting it go seems to be the way forwards. This is the reason why on the dig weekend for the people who are in on it, that we're going to do the Saturday as the digging, a bit of tidying off on a Sunday morning, and I'm going to ask them to bring their bikes as well so that for two reasons. For one, on the Sunday afternoon we can get some tyres on stuff and bed stuff in, which is obviously in any kind of build is really important. But secondly, because for opinions, so far on here, on get to the chopper, I've had five people testing, so six including myself, and only two out of the six have come down and been completely happy to hit into the step down, and then over the gap after the step down. Right, so that's one third of people are cool with doing it. So that kind of tells us that this is, you know, not for everybody straight away. But the weird thing is, having just been over there and tried out a couple of pieces of elementary, they don't feel just as easy as this does to me. But the issue that I've got there with is my kind of perception of it is a bit clouded, because I've had longer to have a go at this, and it's just like day one of having a go at that. So how do I know which one I actually find easier? Because one's very, very new, and one I've had like three or four turns at. So again, another good thing to get other people's opinions and in on it. So that's the kind of plans. A lot of this video today I'm just kind of thinking out loud, and I'm going to use it as much for my benefit to look back on, and because like I say, once I messed about with that car park, I might have forgotten how I felt about this, and I do need to know so that I can, you know, make these tracks better. And that's what it's all about. It's just striving for making them the best they can be. Well, this is exactly why we have days like this. I've just been over to the gap jump, get to the chopper, to have a try on that and try and do some A/B testing. And I forgot to bring my tape measure with me. I've left it next to the laptop. It was a daft move, but so I used bike length to measure it out instead. So I've measured up on the gap jump. It's from tranny to landing is exactly two bike lengths when I measure it by mine, from bottom of the wheels to anyway, two have measured mine. So using that same measurement, I measured two on this whoops, and that line that I've put in there is two lengths. Now if I stand back a bit and show you, hopefully it's showing up on the GoPro, but so for that line there to hit that, making it the same as the gap jump, that is case or armour, and you're going to need a good lawyer for that one. Not confidence inspiring at all. The other point that's a very important point is you're actually coming out of a step down over on that one, and on the gap jump you don't pedal, you hit the step down and just let the compression take you and up and over. So you're actually hitting it at a lot more speed than coming out of this corner. Therefore, this jump needs to be changed. Sometimes you just got to admit when you're wrong and make the necessary changes. And you know what? That's what days like today are here for. So it's goodbye to this. It appears I'm, you know, tested it, it didn't work. It's good fun as a kind of a roller thing, but the point of elementary is I want to get used to having your wheels off the ground. So goodbye to this, and as if by magic, boom, shortened whoop section, longer landing area. Now before I worry about making it look pretty, I need to test it, see how this thing actually rides. I mean, it's a shorter whoop, longer landing, you know, what can you say? Let's give it a go anyway. So have the changes made this jump a whole lot easier? Well, in truth, yes they have, but that was the point. I guess if some of you guys are watching this and thinking, oh man, what did you change it for? I could have hooked that. Then really, on a venue that's going to be 25 plus tracks, and this being called elementary and track 3 on the difficulty level, I'm guessing that this wasn't the track that you were coming to ride anyway. Really, to make sense of it all, I need to cater the tracks to the people who are going to ride them most. And you know, the truth is, there's a lot of people out there that would have just left it as originally and hooked it, no worries. But that, you know, again, that's probably not the one. This track isn't probably the one that you would want to ride. So, you know, it's just how it is. And I'm thinking it's a lot easier now, and therefore confidence inspiring, and that's the point about elementary. Well, I'm hot and I'm tired, but it's been a pretty successful day. I mean, even learning that I'd got the first jump in at the second, sorry, with the first kind of double on elementary wrong, it gave me an opportunity to make it right. So, you know, school day every day, I suppose. But, you know, the first two up at the top of elementary are running as they should do now. As I make way down, it's fairly straightforward. It's berms and stuff, and a few twists and turns. It's pretty much already roughed out, so we'll get I'll park that one now and leave it for the trail crew to help me out with. I'm going to be pretty much concentrating on making sure that I can get these 52 car parking spaces sorted out. That's kind of the next job. So I'm not sure when I'm going to be back on a bike again. So just before I head home, I'm just going to have one last little play on, get to the chopper, because it's rad. Anyway, thanks very much for watching, and thanks very much for your support. And I'll keep you updated and see you soon.